大家早上好，让我们一起来赞美我们这位伟大的神， Amen， Come on。承诺是鲜明你的爱，奇妙主荣耀神何等的伟大，耶、yeah, 舍弃尊贵的君王，超乎万民在全地之上，为我罪流宝血赎回我生命，耶、yeah, 无人能与你相比，你掌权直到永远，我要扬声赞美你。Everybody, come on! Oh, 赞伟大的爱，仿佛如天深海，大手极大赞美。祝、oh, 你满有能力，世界盼望是你。我要敬拜你，耶稣我的主，用我全能的主宰，道成肉身显明你的爱，奇妙主荣耀神何等的伟大，甚至尊贵的君王，超乎万民在权力之上，为我罪流宝血赎回我生命，无人能与你相比，你掌权直到永远，我要扬声赞美你。Everybody, 一起来！哦，何等伟大的爱，高过诸天深海，大手极大赞美。哦，祝你满有能力，世界盼望是你，我要敬拜你。想必你掌权直到永远，我要扬声赞美你。哦哦，那伟大的爱，高过诸天深海，大手极大赞美。哦哦，祝你满有能力。世界盼望是你，我要敬拜你。哦，何等伟大的爱，高过诸天深海，大手极大赞美。哦，祝你满有能力。世界盼望是你，我要敬拜你。一起宣告，我要敬拜你。再次宣告，我要敬拜，我要敬拜你，耶稣我的主。敬拜你，不断不断地来到你面前敬拜你，高声欢呼，耶稣，没有人能和你相比。
Against What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is,
oh Jesus. You are the name that saves,
Jesus.
No other name, no other name, no other name but the name of
deepest time of need, that when we couldn't save ourselves, that you came and you rescued us. And by your cross, Jesus, you brought us from death to life. And even death could not hold you, Jesus, because you rose again. And that's why you have no rival, you have no equal, and you reign. So this morning, Jesus, we want to stand and declare that Jesus belongs all praise and all glory and all honor, and that yours is the kingdom and that yours is the glory, Lord Jesus. And so we thank you that you are such a worthy God, worthy to be praised. And we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning, church.
教会早安.
We're so excited you can join us today.
非常兴奋你可以参与我们今天早上.
Welcome to our online service.
欢迎大家出席我们今天的线上崇拜。
You know, this year has been a year of great testing and trials.
那今年是充满了一个挑战和试探的一年。
There are times when we feel weak.
有很多时候我们觉得自己很软弱。
But you know, the Bible says that when we are weak, we can be strong in God.
但是圣经告诉我们说，当我们软弱的时候，我们就刚强了。
So I hope that you are growing stronger in Jesus Christ.
我希望大家都在主里面越长越刚强。You
know, a strong church is like a tree planted by streams of water.
你知道吗? 一个刚强的教会就好像栽种在溪水旁的树一样。
It is not afraid of the sun.
它不怕太阳晒。
Its leaf will not wither.
它的叶子也必不枯干。
It is not afraid of the storms.
它也不怕暴风雨。
Because its roots are very deep.
因为它的根已经扎得很深。
And it is a tree that will bear fruit in the right season.
并且它会是按时候结果子的树。
That is a picture that God desires for all of us.
这就是上帝要看见我们的一个图片。
And so this week I just want to remind us about the vision that we have for this year.
那所以今天我们要再次提醒大家我们今年的这一个意向。
And that's called a strong church.
就是一个刚强的教会。
And I believe today is a day for us to be strong in God.
我相信今天就是那一天我们要在神里面更加的刚强。
We can get strong in God.
我们可以在主里面更刚强。
You know, it doesn't matter that we are weak.
如果我们是软弱的话, 那是没问题的。
It doesn't even matter if everyone else is weak.
甚至是每一个人都很软弱也没问题。
What matters is what you and I are doing to get strong in God.
那更重要的是你和我是学习更加的刚强在主里。
And we can let Jesus Christ strengthen us.
我们可以让神，让耶稣基督来刚强我们。
And that's why today I want to bring us to talk about Matthew chapter 16, verse 18.
那今天我们要来看的是马太福音第16章。
You know, Jesus said to Peter, "That, and I tell you that you are Peter, And on this rock, I will build my church.
耶稣告诉彼得说，你是彼得，我会把教会建立在这磐石上。
And the gates of hell will not overcome it.
那阴间的权柄不会胜过他。
You know, a strong church is a church that is rooted in Jesus Christ.
而刚强的教会就是扎根于基督的教会。
A strong church is a church that is rooted in strong values.
刚强的教会是扎根于非常刚强的价值的。
And if we desire to make a difference in this world, we must be different from the world.
如果我们要在这个世界带来不一样的果效的话，那么我们必须跟这个世界不一样。
That's why we're going to talk about strong values.
这就是为什么我们今天要来探讨刚强的价值。
Let us pray.
让我们来祷告。
Lord Jesus, we thank you that when we are weak, we can be strong in you.
主耶稣，我们感恩，因为我们知道什么时候我们软弱的时候，我们可以在你里面找到刚强。
And we pray today that we will be strong in our values.
主，我们祷告说，我们今天开始可以在我们的价值上面是刚强的。
Values that are rooted in Jesus Christ.
这些价值要在主里面扎根。
Values that doesn't change even though the world is changing.
这些价值不会改变，纵使世界瞬息万变。
Values that will help us to become a strong church.
这些价值会帮助我们成为刚强的教会。
We pray your blessing on everyone right now.
我们祷告神的祝福临到每一个人身上。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的名我们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So friends, you know, I want to talk about strong values.
朋友们，今天我们要来谈论的是刚强的价值。
Because, you know, we might have a wonderful vision in God.
我们可能在主里面有一个很美好的意象。
But the vision will never be fulfilled unless we have strong values to support that vision.
但是如果那个意象没有一个刚强的价值去支撑它的话，它是永远都不可能实现的。
And when our values are from God's word, from the Bible, we can be sure.
当我们的价值是来自于神的话语的时候，我们可以很确定。
We can be sure that we are building on the right foundation.
我们可以很确定话，我们自己是建立在磐石上的。
Jesus told Peter,
耶稣告诉彼得说
that,I will build my church.
我会把我的教会建立
on this rock.
在这磐石上。
See, it all begins with Jesus.
它从耶稣开始。
And you know, when we are clear about our values in Jesus Christ,
当我们很清楚地晓得我们在基督里面的价值，
it is not difficult to make decisions.
它是不会难让我们去做决定了。
Someone said this.
有人这么说。
He said, it is not hard to make decisions once we know what our values are.
如果我们已经知道我们的价值的话，那么我们就不会难做决定。
So the clearer we are about our values,
如果我们更清晰于自己的价值，
the easier it becomes to make decisions.
我们就更容易的去做决定。
And when our values are beliefs based on God's word, it strengthens our decision making.
当我们的价值能够扎根于我们的信仰在神的话语里面的时候，它会帮助我们更容易的做决定。
Strong values will guide our faith.
这个刚强的价值能够引导我们的信心。
It will influence our decision making.
它会影响我们的决定。
It will help us in making certain practices.
它会影响我们的一些的行为。
And it also gives us the strong motivation.
它也给我们很刚强的推动力。
Now, in our church, we believe in five strong values.
在我们的教会当中，我们相信有五个很重要的刚强的价值。
And these are the values that we are living, even now.
这些价值是我们现在要活出来的。
It is our way of life now.
就是我们现在的生活。
And we see it more in certain people.
我们可以看在一些的人身上更加看见这些价值。
Because they understand more and they move stronger.
因为他们更加理解这些价值，并且把它操练出来。
But our prayer is that all of us will grow strong in all these values.
但是我们的祷告是我们每一个人都可以更加刚强在这些价值当中。
So what are the five values that we value in our church?
那五个我们在教会里面很看重的价值到底是什么呢？
All of them start with G.
这一些在英文字母当中都从 G 开始。
So I call it the five G's.
英文可以把它称为 five G.
And the first one is about God's Son.
第一个讲到的是神的儿子。
We value Jesus Christ, God's Son.
我们看重的是神的孩子，耶稣基督。
God's one and only begotten Son.
我们神的唯一的独生儿子。
Jesus is everything to us.
耶稣是我们的一切。
And we believe that our life revolve around Jesus.
我们相信说我们的一切的生命都是围绕着耶稣的。
He is the reason for our life.
他就是我们生命的意义。
He is the reason why we do what we do.
他就是那个原因为什么我们在做我们现在做的事。
He is the reason why we have supernatural life.
他也是那个原因为什么我们能够活出非凡的生命。
Whatever decision we make in life, we go back to what would Jesus do?
不管我们在生命当中要做什么决定，我们都可以回到这个原点，耶稣他会怎么做？
You see, Jesus is our everything.
耶稣他是我们的一切。
He's our everything because he first loved us.
他是我们的一切，因为他先爱我们。
And because of his love, we have a relationship with God.
因着他的爱，我们跟神之间有了一层的关系。
And because of Jesus, we have a new identity.
也因着耶稣，我们有一个崭新的身份。
We are no longer the same.
我们从此不再一样。
We are now in Christ.
我们如今活在基督里。
And it is Christ who lives in us.
也是基督活在我们里头。
This life we live by faith in the Son of God who loves us.
我们所活的生命，我们活在基督里面，透过耶稣基督活在我们里面。
Because of Jesus Christ, the old has gone, the new has come.
因着耶稣基督，旧事已过，都变成新的了。
We are new creations.
我们是新造的人。
It's all about Jesus.
都关乎于耶稣基督。
And so our significance, our value as a person, is found in what Jesus has done for us at the cross.
所以我们的重要性，我们的价值，我们活着的价值，是在耶稣在十架上所付上的工价当中找到的。
Our value doesn't come from how much money we have or our qualification.
我们的价值不会从我们的财富或者说我们的学历当中找到。
Our value doesn't come from what people say about us.
也不会从别人的嘴巴的评价当中找到。
Even though what they say may be true and good.
纵使在他们的口中的你也许是真的，也许是对的。
Our supreme value is found in Jesus Christ.
但是我们终极的价值是来自于耶稣基督。
That's why our life is so different.
这就是为什么我们的生命可以如此的不同。
And so when we say that we value God's Son,
所以当我们说我们看重神的儿子，
it will show in the way we live.
它会从我们的生活方式当中展现出来。
When we say that Jesus is our everything,
当我们说到耶稣是我们的一切，
it will show in everything.
它会从我们的一切当中展现出来。
There are three things that really help us in our relationship with Jesus Christ.
有三件事情会帮助我们跟神之间的关系。
And because we value Jesus, we value knowing Jesus.
因着我们看重耶稣基督，我们就会更加看重去认识他。
Because we value Jesus, we value obeying Jesus.
因为我们看重耶稣基督，所以我们看重顺服他。
Because we value Jesus, we value witnessing for Jesus.
因为我们看重耶稣基督，因此我们也看重为他做见证。
So there are three things I have just mentioned.
所以三件事我们刚才提到了。
The first is about knowing Jesus.
第一个就是认识神。
How do we get to know Jesus?
我们如何更加的去认识神？
We know Jesus more and more through the Bible.
我们透过圣经更加的认识神。
And we know Jesus.Because he said in Luke chapter 24, verse 27,
我们可以透过圣经，路加福音二十四章二十七节里面说到的。
Jesus said that all the scriptures was talking about himself.
这里讲到说，凡经上所指自己的话，都是他们讲明白了。
You know, the Bible reveals Jesus.
整本圣经彰显的都在指向耶稣。
So we read the Bible not so much for knowledge.Only, but we read for relationship.
所以当我们去阅读圣经的时候，我们并不是单单的只是求知识，更加的是去求跟耶稣之间的关系。
And as you read the word of God,
当你去阅读神的话语，
we also know that God is speaking to us.
我们晓得说这些神跟我们说话。
God wants us to be transformed in our own lives.
神他要我们的生命得着蜕变。
God wants us to become more like Jesus.
他要我们越来越像基督。
And that's why we read in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17.
这就是为什么我们在提摩太后书里面三章十六到十七节里面看到。
He say all scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work.
圣经 都是神所默示的，于教训、度责、使人归正、教导人学义，都是有益的，叫属神的人得以完全，预备行各样的善事。
So the Bible is teaching us how to be like Jesus.
圣经是在教导我们如何更加像耶稣。
How we can be equipped for every good work?
我们如何来装备自己来行善？
The more we know Jesus,
我们更加的认识耶稣时
the more we'll be transformed.
我们生命更加得着蜕变
And when we read the word of God,
当我们去阅读神的话语
we respond to God in prayer.
我们在祷告上回应神
we talk to God about what we understand.
我们跟神来聊我们所理解的
we talk to God about our struggles.
我们跟神来聊我们的挣扎
we talk to God about whatever that is in our heart.
我们可以跟神来聊一切我们心里面的
we talk to Jesus, that's what we call prayer.
我们跟耶稣讲话，这就是我们所说的祷告。
And we worship Jesus.
我们敬拜耶稣。
Because we see how good He is in our everyday life.
因为我们看见他在我们日常生活当中是有多美好。
And because we love Jesus, that's why we want to obey Jesus.
也因着我们爱耶稣，所以我们要来顺服于他。
It is in obeying Jesus that we become transformed to be more and more like Him.
也因着我们越来越顺服基督，那么我们的生命会蜕变，越来越像耶稣基督。
See, this is what we mean by Jesus my everything.
这就是一表，这就是能够从这里能看到我们耶稣是我们的一切。
We want to be more like Him.
因为我们要变得更加像他。
In 1 John chapter 2 verse 6, the Bible says.
在约翰一书二章六节里面说到
，Whoever claims to live in Jesus must live as Jesus did.
人若说他住 在主里面，就该照着主所行的去行。
You see, whoever wants to be like Jesus,
那一些想要像耶稣基督的
，We need to look at Jesus.
我们需要去观察耶稣
，How he lived,
他如何生活
，And that becomes the pattern for our life.
那就是我们应该生活的模式。
And Paul says in Galatians chapter 4 verse 19 that he has this desire for every Christian.
保罗在加拉太书四章十九节有讲到说，这是他对所有基督徒的一个渴望。
This is how Paul says it.
保罗这么说。
He said, "My dear children, for whom I am again in the pains of childbirth, until Christ is formed in you."
保罗是在这么说的。我小子啊，我为你们在受生产之苦，只等到基督成形在你们心里。
In other words.We are talking about wanting to see Christ take over our lives more and more.
换句话说，就是我们要看见耶稣基督在我们生命当中掌权越来越多。
And because of Jesus, we are not ashamed of the gospel.
也因着耶稣，我们不为福音感到羞耻。
Wherever we go, we want to witness for Jesus.
不管我们往哪里去，我们都要见证基督。
And we witness through the power of the Holy Spirit.
我们可以透过圣灵的能力来做见证。
That Jesus said in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you.
在使徒行传一章八节里面讲到说，但圣灵降在你们身上，你们就必得着能力。
And you'll be my witnesses.
你要为我做见证。
In Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth.
在撒玛利亚、犹大全地。和直到地极。
You see, when Jesus is our everything, we want to witness for Jesus.
你看，当耶稣是成为我们一切的时候，我们就想要为他做见证。
And He can lead us every day in our lives through the Holy Spirit.
他可以透过圣灵在我们日常生活当中去引导我们。
He can help us to be His witnesses.
他可以帮助我们成为他的见证。
And that's where Romans chapter 8 verse 14 says.
在罗马书八章第十四节这么说道。
Those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God.
因为凡被神的灵所引导的，都是神的儿子。
So we learn to be led by the Holy Spirit.
我们要学习被圣灵来引导。
This morning I was led by the Holy Spirit.
那今天早上我就被圣灵来引导。
I was having breakfast.
我在吃早餐。
And I saw an old lady. She was bent over, and she was selling food.
我看到一个老太太，她驼着她的背，她在卖食物。
She should be about 80 plus years old.
看起来大约八十多岁左右。
And my heart was touched.
我的心里面很被触动。
I was thinking, God, she is so old. Does she still need to work?
我心里面觉得说，她这么老了，她为什么还需要工作呢？
What happened to her family?
她的家庭到底发生了什么事？
But at that moment, I didn't buy.
但是那当下我没有买任何东西。
I saw her walk away.
我看见她走开了。
But my heart was stirred.
我的心里很被搅动。
Because Jesus is my everything.
因着耶稣是我的一切。
I want to do what He tells me to do.
我要去做他要我做的事。
So finally, I got up from where I was and I went to look for her.
最后我就站起来去找那位老太太。
By that time, she was in some other place. It's a huge area.
在那时候我去找她的时候，她已经走到别的地方了。但是那个地方很大。
And I was ready to bless her financially.
我已经预备好要在经济上祝福她。
I'm not interested in buying food from her.
我不想要跟她买食物。
But I want to bless her.
我要祝福她。
But more than that, I want to share about Jesus to her.
更重要的是，我要把耶稣分享给他。
So when I bought the food,
当我跟他买食物的时候
you know, I start to talk with her.
我就开始跟他聊天。
And I share about Jesus to her.
跟他分享耶稣基督。
You know, when Jesus is our everything, our life is changed.
当耶稣是我们的一切的时候，我们的生命会改变。
We don't do just what we want.
我们不会做我们自己想要做的事。
We do what Jesus put in our heart.
我们会做耶稣放在我们心里的事。
So this is the first value.
这是第一个价值。
The second value,
第二个价值
is God's family.
是神的家庭。
We value God's family.
我们看重神的家庭。
We believe that we are stronger together as God's family.
我们相信说我们神的家庭在一起的时候可以更刚强。
There is a saying that says, united we stand, divided we fall.
有一句话说到我们在一起的时候我们是更刚强的，当我们分开来的时候我们就瓦解了。
And this is true about God's family as well.
在神的家里面，这句话也是正确的。
In a time of COVID-19, everybody start to think only about themselves.
在这个整个新冠肺炎的疫情当中，每个人都只关注到自己的需要。
We may no longer care for each other as much.
我们没有像以前那么去关心其他人。
We don't look forward to meeting together face to face.
我们不再面对面的去见人了。
But the thing is this.
但是重点是
God's heart is that we don't give up meeting together.
神的心意就是我们不能够停止聚会。
But that when we come together, we have to encourage and spur one another on towards love and good deeds.
我们要在聚集在一起，然后彼此的鼓励，彼此的行善。
That's why we value meeting up face to face.
这就是为什么我们会很看重我们能够在真正的面对面的一些聚会。
If you are healthy,
如果你很健康
，you have no medical condition,
你没有任何的医药状况
，and you take proper SOP,
你能够遵行标准的作业程式
，we should meet.
我们应该要见面
，and encourage each other.
来彼此鼓励
to grow strong together,
使到我们可以一起更刚强。
Now this is the heart of Jesus.
这就是耶稣的心意。
You know, one time, Jesus was talking with many people.
有一次，耶稣在跟很多人说话。
And from his sharing, we understand something more about family.
当他在他们的对话当中，我们可以看见这个家庭的这个真正价值。
We read this from Mark chapter 3, verse 33 to 35.
我们可以在马可福音第三章33到35节里面看见。
And Jesus said, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" He asked.
耶稣回答说，谁是我的母亲，谁是我的弟兄？
Then he looked at those seated in a circle around him and said, "Here are my mother and my brothers."
就四面观看那些周围坐着的人说，看哪，我的母亲，我的弟兄。
You know, those people were not his own flesh and blood.
那一些人事实上并不是跟他有血缘关系的人。
But what Jesus is saying is this.
那耶稣他想说的是
，In verse 35,
35节里面看见
，Jesus said, "Whoever does God's will is my brother and sister and mother."
凡遵行神旨意的人，就是我的兄弟姐妹和母亲了。
In other words, when we desire to do God's will, we enter into a new family called God's family.
换句话说，当我们愿意去做神的旨意的时候，我们进入一个新的家庭，就是神的家庭。
So you and I, because we believe in Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, we are now in God's family.
你和我因着我们相信耶稣基督，那现在我们在神的家庭当中。
And as a family, we look forward to meeting together.
那作为一个家庭的话，我们会很期待见面。
Because we understand this word called covenantal relationship.
因为我们能够理解，这就是有盟约的关系。
We have entered into a relationship with God.
我们进入了跟神之间的关系。
Through Jesus Christ, we became the children of God.
透过耶稣基督，我们成为神的孩子。
Through Jesus Christ, we become God's family.
透过耶稣基督，我们成为神的家的一份子。
And through Jesus Christ, we become family members.
也透过耶稣基督，我们成为一家人。
So even though we may have different surnames,
或者我们有不同的姓,
but in Jesus Christ, we are the same family.
但是在基督里面，我们是一家人。
And when we're in the same family, we love each other.
当我们在一个家庭当中的时候，我们是彼此相爱的。
We take care of each other.
我们彼此关怀照顾。
We do the best for each other.
我们把最好的都献给彼此。
And that's the way a family is meant to be.
这就是一个家庭的真正意义。
And you know, in this covenantal relationship as God's family, there is strong love.
在这个有盟约的一个家庭关系当中，它是有很强烈的爱。
There's a strong obedience to Jesus' command.
并且有很强烈的顺服于基督的诫命。
For example, in John chapter 13, verse 34 and 35.
打个例子，在约翰福音十三章34到35节里面说到
，Jesus says to us, "A new command I give you, love one another." As I have loved you, so you must love one another.
我赐给你们一条新的命令，乃是叫你们彼此相爱。我怎样爱你们，你们要如何相爱。
Verse 35, by this everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another.
35节里面说到，你们若有彼此相爱的心，众人因此就认出你们是我的门徒。
And you know, this is how we live.
这就是我们活着的方式。
So this morning, I bought the butter buns from that old lady.
在今天早上我买了牛油包从这个老太太身上。
And then we come to do the recording.
然后来到这个录音的阶段的时候。
I gave the butter buns to different ones.
我就把这个牛油包派给不同的人。
So you see, I'm not making up any story. This is real.
我不是在编故事，这是真实的。
We show love in practical ways.
我们是很实际的把爱活出来。
It's so wonderful to be in God's family.
是很美好的一件事，我们在神家庭当中。
And in this God's family, there are four things I want to suggest about how we relate to one another.
在这个神的家庭当中，我要提议大家四个方式，我们可以如何来彼此联系。
For example, we choose to forgive one another.
打个例子，我们要彼此的来原谅。
We will all have differences.
因为我们彼此很不同。
We have different views, different tastes, different ideas.
我们有不同的观点，我们有不同的口味，我们有不同的想法。
But all these differences doesn't need to break us up.
但是这一些的不同呢，不会把我们分歧。
Because through Jesus, even though we have differences, we can forgive each other.
因为透过耶稣基督，纵使我们是很不同，但是我们可以彼此原谅。
Second way we love as a family is we choose to honor one another in action and speech.
另外一个方式就是我们可以去尊荣人的话语和行为。
We think before we speak.
我们在还没有说话之前先思考。
We think about how to build people up instead of tearing them down.
我们去想我们要如何去建立一个人，而不是毁掉一个人。
We don't talk bad behind people's back.
我们不要在人家的背后说他的坏话。
We don't gossip.
我们不说闲言闲语。
See, that's how we function as a family.
这就是一个家庭应该要有的样式。
And beyond that, we believe the best for one another.
那除此之外，我们也要相信彼此最好的一面。
We are always thinking about how to bring out the best in our brother and sisters in Christ.
我们常常要去想说，我们要如何把弟兄姐妹最美好的一面带出来。
And in all that we do, we have a heart to.Care and protect one another.
在一切我们所做的事情上面，我们都要有一颗爱的心，一个关爱、关怀的心去保护彼此。
So you see, we live as a family.
我们是以一家人的方式活的。
And thirdly, another value that is very important.
那第三个很重要的一个价值是
？It is called generosity.
就是慷慨。
We value being generous.
我们要看重慷慨。
We value being.Generous because our God is generous to us.
我们要看重慷慨，是因为我们的神对我们是非常慷慨的。
You know, God generously gave His one and only Son, Jesus Christ, to die for our sins.
你知道吗？神他是非常慷慨的，给予他的唯一的独生儿子来为着我们的罪。
So that we may enter into the kingdom of heaven.
使到我们可以走进天国。
And God has generously given us.Every spiritual blessing in Jesus Christ.
那神也很慷慨的，透过耶稣基督把所有的属灵的福分给了我们。
And because we understand the generosity of God towards us,
那当我们能够理解到上帝对我们的慷慨时，
We also desire to be generous in our lives towards other people.
那我们对别人的生命也要是慷慨的。
And we believe that this is the way for us to show our love for God.
我们相信说这是其中一个我们彰显对神爱的方式。
You see, Matthew 22 says, talks about loving God and loving people.
在马太福音22章里面讲到说我们要爱神爱人。
And in fact, Jesus explained in Matthew 22 verse 39,
那其实耶稣也在马太福音22章39节里面解释到，
He said, love your neighbor as yourself.
就是要爱人如己。
Our neighbor are the people around us.
我们的邻舍就是那一些我们旁边的人。
Our neighbors could be the school that we are at.
也许是我们所在的学校。
It could be the town that you live in.
也可以是你所在的城市。
It could be the residential area where you stay.
也可能是你的住宅区。
You know, our neighbors are everywhere.
我们的邻舍是无处不在的。
So this morning, the 80 plus year old auntie is my neighbor.
那今天早上这80多岁的老太太就是我的邻舍。
I was concerned for her.
我很关心她。
I was ready to, in fact, I gave her more than what the food cost.
其实我给她的钱是多过于那个食物的价钱。
I don't want to bargain.
我不要跟她讨价还价。
I don't want any change.
我也不要她找我钱。
I just want to show the love of Jesus.
我就是要彰显耶稣基督的爱。
And in fact, I asked her.
那事实上我也问她。
I said, Auntie, how is your home?
我就问她，太太，你的这个家到底是怎样的？
Do you have a home?
你有家吗？
And how's the situation at home?
你的家庭的情况又是怎样的？
And then she shared that she had many sons.
她分享说她有很多的儿子。
And that she is doing okay.
她讲她的生活还是不错的。
And so I asked, why are you still selling food at such an old age?
我就问她说，为什么你还在这么年迈的时候还要出来卖食物呢？
And at the back of my mind, I was prepared to call a few people to jump into action and help already.
在我的思想里面，我已经想到说，我已经想到几个人可以进来帮忙了
，including myself，
包括我自己在内。
But she said that actually her home is okay.
她就分享说，其实她的家庭没问题。
She was still selling at her age because she wants to do something.
她在这个八十多岁的年纪还在卖东西，因为她想要做一些事情。
She finds it boring to stay at home.
因为在家很无聊。
So praise the Lord.
赞美神。
You see, you know, we must be generous with our time.With our money, with our care for people.
我们要很慷慨地给予我们的金钱，我们的时间，还有我们的关怀。
I want to suggest four things we can consider about generosity.
我要提议大家四件事情关乎于这个关怀。
All these four depends on our understanding that nothing that we have belongs to us. We are just stewards.
这四个东西呢，都会提醒我们说，这些我们所拥有的都不属于我们，我们只是管家。
Our money, our house, our car, everything we have actually is not ours. It belongs to God.
我们的家，我们的钱，我们的屋子，我们所有的一切都来自于神，是属于神的，不是我们的。
Our giftings, our talents,
我们的才干，我们的能力。
Our education,
我们的教育。
You know, whatever.
所有的一切。
So these are four things.
这就是那四点。
I want to suggest that.We are to steward our God-given resources and talents and use it for the sake of the gospel.
我要提醒大家，提议大家，就是我们要好好的管理神所给我们的资源，去来建立神的家。
We give of our time.
我们给我们的时间。
We give of our effort.
我们奉献我们的努力。
We give of our skills.
把我们的能力，我们的技巧。
That's how we steward who we are.
这就是我们如何去管理我们的才干，我们自己本身。
And as stewards with a heart of generosity, we are actively taking part in giving hope and transforming lives wherever we are.
当我们能够好好的去管理这些神给我们的资源的时候，其实我们是在很主动的去参与，去给人家带来希望，并且去转变生命。
And when we meet people with different needs in their lives.
当我们遇到他们不同的人有不同的需要的时候
，We do our best to meet those needs holistically.
我们会尽全力的去帮助这些人满足他们全方位的需求。
And in our life, we also seek to be salt and light.
那我们生命当中，我们也要成为那份盐和光。
To be people who do good to other people.
就成为那个能够去祝福人、做善行在别人身上的人。
Now.We don't do good in order to be saved.
我们并不是因为要得着救恩而去做善事。
We do good because we have been saved by Jesus.
我们行善的原因的动力是因为我们被神拯救了。
So Jesus put it this way in Matthew chapter 5.
在马太福音第五章，耶稣这么说。
I just want to read verse 16.
我们来看第十六节。
Jesus says, talking about salt and light, he said, in the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven.
在第十六节里面这么说到，你们的光也当这样照在人前，叫他们看见你们的好行为，便将荣耀归给你们天上的父。
So you know, let us be generous in good deeds.
所以让我们在我们的善行里面是慷慨的。
And it can be as simple as giving someone a glass of water.
它可以简单到把一杯水拿给一个人。
Be generous with our words.
我们可以很慷慨在我们的言语上。
Speak kindly to people, whoever they are.
我们可以跟任何人都说好话。
You know, think about this word generosity.
我们还可以去思考这个字慷慨。
Be generous.
我们要成为慷慨的一员。
Make a difference in the world.
我们要把世界带来不一样的效果。
That is one of the most important value we have.
这就是其中一个我们最重要的一个价值了。
We want to enrich the lives of people in the community.
我们要丰富我们旁边的社群的人的生命。
A fourth value that we cherish is called generations.
那第四个价值我们很珍惜的就是世代。
What is generations all about?
世代观到底是什么呢？
It is all about raising generation after generation of disciples of Jesus Christ.
它就关乎于兴起一代又一代的神的门徒。
And this is something that actually began even in the book of Genesis.
这个其实就甚至在创世纪就开始了。
When God created all of creation,
当神他创造了所有的创造物，
He said, be fruitful and multiply.
他说你要倍增。
He said that to the plants and the trees, be fruitful and multiply.
他说他对植物，他对那些树也这么说，要结果子，要倍增。
He said to all the living creatures, be fruitful and multiply.
他跟所有的活物都这么说，要倍增，要多结果子。
And he said the same to Adam and Eve, be fruitful and multiply.
他同时也跟亚当和夏娃这么说，要倍增，要多结果子。
See, God is interested in raising generations.
你可以看到上帝是很有兴趣在这个兴起世代的。
And when Jesus gave us the Great Commission in Matthew chapter 28,
当耶稣他给下我们这个大使命在马太福音28章，
When he said, go and make disciples of all nations,
他说去使万民做我的门徒。
What is that all about?
它关乎于什么？
That is about raising generations of Christ-centered disciples.
就是要兴起符合基督的门徒们。
So in our church, we value seeing the young to the old, everyone is a disciple of Jesus.
所以在我们教会当中，我们很看重从年老到年少都是神的门徒。
We value seeing that everyone is being equipped in their life to be a powerful witness for Jesus.
我们要看见说每一个人都被装备成为很有能力的见证人。
And in that sense, we really believe in what we call the fivefold equipping.
所以我们在这个情况，我们就是看到那个五重的执事的装备。
This is found in Ephesians chapter 4.
我们可以在以弗所书第四章看见。
Verse 11 to 13.
在第十一节到第十三节。
And it says that Jesus Christ himself gave to the church apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers.
他讲到说，耶稣所给教会的有使徒、先知，有传福音的，有牧师和教师。
And they are to equip God's people for works of service.
他是要成全圣徒，各尽其职。
So what we're seeing here is we want to see generations of disciples being raised. All of them are equipped.To serve in all kinds of ministry.
我们要看见的是不同的阶层的这个使徒们、门徒们被兴起来，每一个世代的门徒都要被兴起来，在不同的领域服事。
And every person in every generation.
在每一个世代当中的每一个人。
We want to see them being equipped in those five areas.
我们都要看见他们在这五重知识当中被装备起来。
They are equipped to have a strong foundation in God.
他们可以被装备有拥有非常刚强的一个基础在神里面。
And they are equipped to break through.
他们已经装备好要去突破。
For the kingdom of God.
为着神的国度。
See, that's what we call the apostolic.
那就是使徒。
Strong foundation and breakthrough for God's kingdom.
就是有能够。摆下很强的根基，并且要突破。
They are being light in dark places.
他们能够在黑暗当中成为光芒。
They are able to bring people from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God's light.
他能够把人从黑暗的世界当中带到神的光明。
They are able to break through in their personal sin issues and struggles.
他们能够在他们生命当中自己的挣扎和罪犯罪当中得到一个突破。
A generation that have such breakthroughs in their life.
这一个能够有突破性的一个时代。
And secondly, that all these generations are people who are able to hear God and obey God.
还有就是这个时代，大家都可以来聆听神，能够顺服神的时代。
And they are able to help others to hear God and obey God.
并且能够帮助其他人聆听神、顺服神的时代。
They are able to hear from God and speak for God.
他们可以从神那里聆听，并且来为神而发言。
They are able to hear from God and minister for God.
他们可以从神那里聆听，并且来为神服事。
That's called prophetic.
那就是先知。
We want to see people who are able to do that.
我们要看见人可以这样操作。
In our church, we call it ho ho ho.
在我们的教会当中，我们会把它变成 ho ho ho.
Hear God and obey God.
聆听神，顺服神。
Help others to hear God and obey God.
帮助其他人聆听神，顺服神。
Now, if every one of those believers are also able to share their life testimonies to people,
如果每一个这样子的信徒可以去分享他们生命的见证，
wherever they go, they know how to use different parts of their life story to share about Jesus.
不管他们去到哪里，他们知道说他们要分享他们生命中哪一块的见证。
And they are able to share the good news of what Jesus has done for everyone in the world.
他们可以去分享耶稣基督所做的美好的消息来为着这世上。
That is what we call the evangelistic equipping.
这就是传福音的装备。
And so wherever we go,
不管我们去到哪里，
we are ready to share the good news.
我们就预备好要分享福音。
No matter who we meet,
不管我们见谁，
we are always looking for opportunities to talk about Jesus.
我们都要找机会来分享基督。
What a wonderful lifestyle!
是多么美好的一个生活方式。
And the fourth area of equipping is that we want to equip everyone in every generation to know how to care for somebody else spiritually.
那第四个就是在每一个世代当中帮助每一个人能够去关怀其他人。
Even a 7-year-old boy
甚至是一个七岁的小男孩
can learn to take care of the younger sister or younger brother who is 5 years old.
他们可以学习去照顾那个比他年幼的可能五岁的小男生。
The way the 7-year-old pray, he can model it and help the younger one to also see and learn how to pray.
这个七岁的小男孩的祷告模式可以成为那个五岁小男孩的模板样。
And care for the younger one.
然后他关怀的方式。
See, that's the pastoral equipping.
这个就是牧师的恩赐。
And the last area is called teaching.
那最后就是教师。
That everyone in every generation, they know how to be taught from the word of God.
每一个世代当中的每一个人，他们都晓得如何从神的话语当中教导。
They know how to put into practice the word of God.
他们懂得如何去应用神的话语。
In their practical life.
在他们生活当中实际的应用。
They can see the power and the result of putting God's word into practice.
他们能够看见把神的话语化为实际行动之后带来的能力。
And they are able to teach somebody else to do the same.
他们能够去教导其他人来也如此的操作。
You see, I believe that this fivefold equipping is very powerful.
我相信说这个五重执事的装备是非常有能力的。
And this is how we're going to raise generations.
这就是我们如何去兴起整个世代。
And the fifth value that we have is called the gospel.
那第五个价值就是福音。
We are not ashamed of the gospel.
我们不以福音为耻。
Because it's the power of God.
因为他带着神的大能
for salvation,
带着神的救恩
for everyone in the world,
为这世上的每一个人。
The good news is an eternal, impactful news.
这个好消息是一个永恒性、大有影响力的一个消息。
In other words, it changes the eternal destiny of anyone who believes and receives the good news.
换句话说，它会改变一个能够相信他的人，改变他们永恒的这个终结点。
When we hear the good news, you know, faith comes from hearing the word.
当我们聆听好消息的时候，我们的信心从聆听开始。
And when we hear the word, we respond to the word, it's faith that acts.
当我们聆听这个话语的时候，我们回应，那么就是一个信心的行为。
We believe the gospel.
我们相信福音。
That's how we become a new creation.
这就是为我们如何能够成为新造的人。
At the same time, once we have received the good news in our life,
同时当我们能够领受到这个福音进我们生命
We see that people around us are still living with bad news
我们看见说我们身旁的人许多人还是活在坏消息当中
Their marriage is breaking up
他们的婚姻是非常糟糕
Business failure
他们的生意也失败了
Young people feeling suicidal
年轻人都想要自杀
Or those who do well in their education
那一些读好很会读书的
And they're not doing well.
那些不会读书的
You know, whatever it may be.
不管它是怎样的一个情况
We want to bring the good news.
我们都要把好消息带去
And that's why we act.
这个就是为什么我们要行动
Because we have this faith in the good news, we act to tell others the good news.
也因着我们的这个信心在我们里面，所以我们开始行动出来，我们把福音传给其他人
That's why we desire to pioneer new groups.
这就是为什么我们要去拓殖新的小组。
We want to look for new communities of people.
我们要去看，我们要去找新的社群的人。
We dare to take risks.
我们敢于拿起挑战。
We are not afraid of failure.
我们不害怕失败。
Because when we fail, we still learn.
因为当我们失败的时候，我们还在学习。
And we celebrate the willingness to obey God and try something.
然后我们就去庆贺说我们愿意去拿起一些新的东西来尝试来顺服神
See, this is all the things that are happening because we believe in the gospel
这就是一些会发生的事当我们愿意去相信福音
So I want to conclude by asking us today
那今天我要以这问一个问题来做总结
When you look at the five values
当我们去看这五个价值
Which one are closest to your heart and strongest in your life?
哪一个在你对你的心来说是最贴切的？哪一个又对你而言是最刚强的
？Praise God for that.
我们赞美神。
But there are some other values that is either totally new to you, or you know about it, but you're not strong in it.
又或者有一些的那一些价值在你里面，你对你而言是很新的一个东西，又或者说你已经知道了，但是没有去操练出来的。
And you realize today that you need to get.Stronger in those values.
然后你今天发现说你要在这一个价值当中要加深。
Would you just begin to open your heart to God?
你是否愿意现在敞开你的心
？I want to pray for all of us right now.
我现在要为我们每个人来祷告。
Father, I thank you for today.
父神，我们为着今天来谢
恩。Where we can have an overview of what it means to have strong values.
我们可以再一次来探讨什么叫做真正的重要的价值。
We value Jesus Christ, God's one and only Son.
我们看重神的孩子，那独生儿子。
Jesus, you are everything.
耶稣，你是我们的一切。
And we thank you that through Jesus Christ, we have become God's family.
我们感谢神，因为透过耶稣基督，我们成为一个家人。
Help us to live in a loving relationship with one another.
帮助我们活出彼此相爱的一个模式。
Help each other to grow in you.
帮助我们彼此在你里面成长。
And we thank you, Lord, that you have put in our heart a heart for generosity.
主啊，我们也感谢你放在我们心里面的慷慨。
That just as we have freely received from you, we freely give to people.
就好像我们从神你那里白白的得着，我们也要白白的舍出去。
We are generous because we understand that whatever we have doesn't belong to us; it belongs to you.
我们慷慨是因为我们知道我们所拥有的一切不是我们自己的，乃是属于神你的。
So we use everything we have for the kingdom of God.
所以我们愿意用我们所拥有的一切为着神的国度。
And we thank you, Lord, that you are concerned not only for our generation, you're concerned for every generation of people.
主，我们也非常感恩，因为我们知道说神你不单只关注我的这个时代，你是关注每一个时代。
We want to see every generation becoming Christ-centered disciples.
我们要看见每一个世代的人都能够成为以基督为中心的时代。
We desire to see every generation, from the young to the old, every generation advancing the gospel of Jesus Christ.
我们要看见每一个世代，从年幼的世代到年老的世代，都能够使福音前进。
Lord, may you speak more into our hearts in the days ahead.
主啊，愿你的话语更多来对我们说话。
That as we strengthen in our values.
当我们更加刚强在神你的价值当中。
As we become stronger in our vision.
当我们的意向里面更加的刚强，
we will be able to become the strong church.
我们就能够成为更刚强的教会。
A church that can give the strength of God to people who are weak.
一个能够把神的力量去带给那一些软弱人的教会。
Because we know that our strength is found in Jesus Christ.
因为我们知道说我们的力量是从耶稣你那里得着。
Bless everyone right now, Lord.
主啊，你祝福现在的每一个人。
Wherever we are, in whatever we're going through.
不管我们在哪里，不管我们经历些什么，
we know that in Jesus Christ we will have the answer.
我们晓得在基督里面我们会有答案。
We thank you, Lord.
我们感谢耶稣。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
So thank you, friends, for joining us today.
朋友们，谢谢你参与我们今天的崇拜。
I've shared with you the five G's.
我跟你们分享的这个五个 G.
These are the strong values that we believe and we live in our lives.
这些都是我们看重，我们非常看重的价值，并且活出来的价值。
We invite you to join us.
我们邀请你一起参与
我们。To grow in such strong values.
在这些价值当中继续的成长。
Thank you. God bless you and bye bye.
谢谢大家，祝福大家，再见。
Good morning, church.
教会早安。
It's a blessing to be online with you wherever you are watching from.
不管你从哪里观看呢，我们都是一种福气，我们可以一起在线上崇拜。
We hope you've been blessed with the worship and the word today.
我希望你们被今天的敬拜和今天的神的话语祝福。
Let us pursue godly values because we are valuable towards the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
让我们一起来追求神的价值，因为我们在万王之王、万主之主的眼中看为珍贵。
Giving is a form of worship to God.
那奉献是一种敬拜神的方式。
Tithing is one of the only areas that God Himself says test Him.
而十一奉献是唯一一项上帝说可以试探他的地方。
And when we bring our tithe to God, He will open the floodgates for us.
当我们愿意把十一奉献带入神的家的时候，我们要看神如何为我们敞开天上的门。
Thus, let us give to Him cheerfully, whether in tithing or offering.
让我们甘心乐意的给予我们的十一奉献和其他的奉献。
You may give via online bank transfer, Sarawak Pay, or even Maybank QR Pay.
你可以透过线上转账 Sarawak Pay 或者 Maybank QR Pay 来给予奉献。
Thank you so much for giving to the Lord.
非常感谢你甘心乐意的给予。
That's all for announcements this week.
那这个礼拜的报告到此为止。
We hope you enjoyed today's service and have a blessed week ahead, loving God and loving others.
我们希望你享受今天的崇拜，祝福你们有个蒙福的一个星期，爱神爱人。
See you next week.
我们下个星期见。
拜拜。
再见。